to share my screen with you.
Ma'am, I can't hear your voice.
Okay, is my voice audible to everyone else?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am, yes, ma'am. Now it's low.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible very good.
Ma'am, now it's audible.
Okay, so there might be some internet issue from your end.
Ma'am, you are not talking, that's all. I thought it was you are talking.
We are going to visit an amazing island, Maldives. So before I start with today's presentation, I would like you to tell some fantastic facts about this place, which make you more exciting to know about this country, okay? So here in Maldives, you can enjoy various adventure sports. And some of the adventure sports of this place is snorkeling, jet skiing, scuba diving, underwater walking, and many more. And I will be showing you a video of all the adventure sports. Yes.
Filled with friendly sharks.
Yes, yes. I'm just talking about it. Please mute your mics. Okay, so in this place, you can swim with friendly sharks. Yes, you have heard it right. So this place has some friendly sharks and you can swim along with them. So the next interesting fact.
They won't bite.
Stop annotating, please, guys.
They won't bite.
No, they are really friendly, so they don't bite you.
Can you stop the presentation?
Yes.
Everyone is scribbling.
Yeah, somebody started annotating, so yes, I had to.
First, Rudra started it.
Okay. Just okay, so is my screen visible to everyone?
Yes, my screen is visible.
Please, Tanvi, don't play with the settings. Tanvi,
oh,
please don't play
hand.
With the settings.
This is a phone, that's why. This is a phone.
I am getting requests from your end, so this is not.
This is a phone, that's why I touched it, that's why it came.
So don't play with settings, please. Okay, so getting back to our presentation. So the next friendly fact I would like to tell you is this place is really lovely and you can enjoy the friendly Maldivian culture. The next one is you can relax on the private and the safe clean beaches. So I must tell you this place has over 1200 small islands and each island you would find is really safe and clean. So the next is you can dive into the coral reef. You can see the bioluminescent water under stars. So do you know what is this bioluminescent? Does anybody know about this term or have you ever heard about this term?
Yes.
Okay, great. So I must tell everyone, this is actually a natural phenomenon that occurs due to the presence of millions of marine microbes, which is known as phytoplankton in the water. So these phytoplankton is a bioluminescent and this occurs because when the sky gets darker after the sunset, these microscopic planktons emit a bright, vibrant blue light in water, which creates an unreal effect. And it really grabs the attention of the tourist. So the next fact is you can visit this architectural heritage of the place. You can get amazing spa therapy over there and also you can explore various islands. Okay, so now I'll work on some geographical facts of the country. Okay, so do you know where is Maldives located?
Yes, ma'am, I know.
Okay. Please tell.
Ma'am in South Asia.
Okay.
Ma'am in South Asia.
Yes, yes. So, just wait for a while. There is a technical issue. I'm sorry for that. Called as Maldives Islands. So this is the independent island country in the north central Indian Ocean. So it consists a chain of about 1200 small coral islands and sandbags. Okay, so here you can see the map of the Maldives. Now, talking upon the flag of the country, so the flag of Republic of Maldives is green with a red border. So the red center bears a vertical white crescent. The closed side of crescent is on the raising side of the flag, and the flag was adopted on 25 July 1965. So on the flag, the red rectangle represents the boldness of the nation's heroes and the willingness to sacrifice the every drop of blood in defense of the country. The green rectangle in the center symbolizes the peace and the prosperity. The white crescent moon symbolizes the Islamic faith of the state and the authorities. Now, we will have a quick overview of the history of this place. So, the history of Maldives is intertwined with the history of broader Indian subcontinent and the surrounding regions, as most of the people often confuse as the people or the government of the India owns Maldives. So no, Maldives is an independent country. So this place comprises of South Asia and Indian Ocean and the modern nation, which consists of 26 natural atolls, which comprise 1194 islands. So historically, the Maldives had a strategic importance because of its location on the major marine routes of the Indian Ocean. So the Maldives gained total independence from the British on 26 July 1965. So you can note it down. The Independence Day for the Maldives is 26 July 1965. However, the British continued to maintain an airways on the island of Gann in the southernmost atoll until 1976. The British departure in 1976 at the height of Cold War almost immediately triggered foreign speculation about the future of the airbase. So apparently the Soviet Union made a move to request the use of base, but the Maldives refused. So now this country is independent from everything and it is known as the Independent Island. So we will be having a quick overview to this country. Talking about the capital and the largest city of Maldives, Malé holds this place. See, you can see a picture over here. This is the place Malé, which is the capital and the largest city. The language spoken here is Divehi. The Divehi language is of Indo-Iranian Sanskrit origin, and therefore it is closely related to Sinhala, which points at a later influence from the north to the subcontinent. Now, talking about the culture and the tradition, so you can see this first picture, right? So this is the attire of the people of the Maldives. So this is how the men and women dress up over there. And talking about the culture, The culture, traditions, and the custom of the countries are influenced by Indian, Sri Lankan, Malaysian, Arab, Persian, Indonesian, and even South and even African influences. So this place has a good amalgamation of the different culture from across the different countries, a fabulous cultural mix that makes it all the richness of the Maldives. Okay. So in music and dance, for example, you will be surprised to recognize a purely African rhythm. Yes, so in music, they have an African rhythm, the Boduberu, which is a traditional Maldivian dance. This illustrates this perfectly. So the language accompanying this dance, followed by the rhythm of the drum, will take you to the East Africa. Now, I will tell you about the government of the Maldives. The Republic of Maldives is an independent island nation. The politics of the Maldives takes place in the framework of presidential representative democratic republic.
Mom, can you tell what is the name of the president?
Yes, yes, I am coming up to that. Please keep yourself mute.
Okay, ma'am.
So, the president is the head government of this place and the executive power is exercised by the government. Okay, so the current president is Ibrahim Mohamed Soli.
Ibrahim Mohamed.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so talking about the current population as of June 2021, here the population is 5,49,261. Now, I will tell about the climate of this place. So the Maldives has a year-round hot tropical climate. The Maldives have two distinct and dominating seasons. The first one is dry season. So the dry season lasts from November to April, which is punctuated with northeast winter monsoons. And the second is the wet season, which lasts from May to October. And this is associated with the southwest monsoons and the strong winds. Okay, talking about the national animal and the bird. So yellowfin tuna is the national animal and white-breasted water hen is the bird. So this yellowfish tuna is moreover eaten by the people over there. So yes, they have a dish that is tuna dish. Now, I will tell about the other animals which are found at this place. So yes, Maldives has exotic wildlife, such as you can see a wide variety of snakes.
There is a lot of snakes there, no ma'am?
Yes,
because it's a greeny place.
Yes, definitely. So that is why this place has wide variety of snakes, reptiles, turtles, birds, and invertebrates. Moreover,
I love turtles.
Yes. So moreover, this place has whales, dolphins, sharks.
Scuba divers go inside and see stingrays and everything and enjoy it.
Yes, you can see it in these pictures.
This is a big stingray that I'm in the center.
Yes, 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 exactly.
They will touch it?
No, no, you can't touch them. You just go close to them.
Okay.
Yes. Now, as of I have told you about this animal wildlife of this place, I would also like to tell about the flora of the Maldives. So if you are wondering what animals are there in the Maldives, then you should also shift your focus to the flora of the Maldives, which come up with the lush green and diverse in its variety. So in the Maldives, the southern and the northern islands are more fertile than the central islands. And of the eastern islands, yes. So a major part of the islands are covered with the dense forest and they exist up and there is an existence of plenty of tropical trees. So you can find there many of the trees such as breadfruit, mango, coconut palm, plantain, and also the banyan trees, which make the islands of the Maldives the picture perfect. Okay, so talking about the traditional sport or the national sport of the Maldives, the bashi. Bashi is the most popular game you have never heard of. So anybody of you has ever heard about this term, Bashi?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so I am going to tell
Aren't
you
about they playing volleyballs?
Yes, I am just going to tell you about this game. What is this game all about? And do you know there is also a vegetable which name same, Bashi. There is a vegetable named Bashi.
No.
Yeah. Okay. So Bashi in the Maldives, can you see this tennis racket in the hand of the girl?
Yes, the ma'am, they are throwing balls in the ground, they are balls.
Okay, so what they do is that tennis rackets are mostly swung by the women to play game Bashi. So this is the traditional sport with the same name as the vegetable. So as this is literally a
If they have term, to catch it, ma'am.
Yes.
If they doesn't catch, the point will decrease.
Okay, so I don't know exact about terms and rules of this game. So, because there is hardly anything written about it online, not even in English. So, this Basketball Foundation has a website and they have a Facebook page. But the page, the language written on that page is Dwehi, the language of the Maldives.
So, we cannot understand it.
Only the local people of this place can elaborate about their game, because unfortunately there are so many languages, right? But only in Wikipedia there was a single paragraph on this sport averages of this place.
Ma'am, so one second, ma'am. Subhanita wants to present the screen now.
Okay, we will do it later. Let me finish first. And Tanvi, please, I request you to mute your mic. You can unmute after my session, okay? Please okay, mute your mic.
Say to Subhanita, okay, ma'am?
Okay, please don't interrupt. It distracts me, please. Okay, now I will talk about the food of this place. So traditional food of Maldives is gula. So this is the national dish of Maldives. And what this dish is about is, like, this is a deep fried pastry ball which is filled with smoked fish such as the Maldive fish or tuna. The tuna which I showed you earlier, the national animal of this place. So this is filled with tuna and this is served with coconut and the onions. So the snacks are usually sold at small cafes or in the shops. So this dish gula is recommended to pair with a cup of hot sweetened tea. People usually have it with the hot tea. The next dish which I will talk to you about is mashrooshi. It is also the traditional Maldivian snack which consists of stuffed and fried dough. The dough is made of flour, oil, warm water, salt, while the filling includes the smoked tuna, grated coconut, hot peppers, onions, garlic, ginger, minced curry leaves, and lime. So you would find these ingredients as same as the North Indians use, right? Okay, so now I will take you to the amazing video of the Maldives. So I request my guests to enjoy this video while keeping your mics mute.
A water park.
Okay, so who's gonna tell me the value of Maldivian rupiah in Indian currency?
Ma'am,
the value of Maldivian rupiah
less than 5 rupees.
4.5 rupees.
Yes.
Less than 5 rupees.
Okay, and what are the adventure sports of this place?
Ma'am, underwater swimming.
Yes.
Ma'am, underwater swimming.
Ma'am, yes. Skydiving. Ma'am, sorry.
Not skydiving.
Ma'am, okay. Scuba diving.
Yes, it's scuba diving. Okay, so now we will move proceed towards our presentation. Please mute your mics. Okay, so now I will talk about the Maldives airline industry. So anybody can guess what's the airline industry of this country? Or anybody know?
Ma'am, are...
Yes, ma'am, can I see?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, can I see?
Yes.
Are Maldivian?
No. Okay. So Maldivian is the airline division of Island Aviation Services, which is based in Male. So the national flag carrier of the Maldives is Maldivian. Okay, so it is a national airline which operates international flights in addition to its inter-island services. This is based in Vilana International Airport. So the Maldivian Airlines operates a fleet size of over 23 and serve over 23 destinations. And also the Maldivian owns the aircrafts from the Airbus A-A300 series, 2-A200 series, and 11 DH-6 twin otter aircraft. So as you can see here, the place is covered with water, right? So they mainly use a seaplane to travel within different islands. You can see a few glimpses of the aircraft. So such type of aircraft are known as seaplane. Now, I will talk about the awards and achievements of this airline. So the National Airline of Maldives received the Airlines Reliability Performance Award back in 2019 for outstanding dispatch reliability from the Bombardier for the 8th time. The Airline Reliability Performance Award is presented to the airline that holds their dispatch reliability at the 99% mark. So with a minimum of technical faults throughout the year, so Maldivian won the award against Oceania countries under the Dash 8 model aircraft categories. Okay, so this was all about from my side for today's tour. So before I talk about anything else, I would like to assign you some tasks as we are having 2 days holidays for Saturday and Sunday. So on Monday, we are going to visit Mauritius. So I would like to assign you the guys, you should paint or draw the national emblem of Mauritius, the national flag of Mauritius, or the national animal of the Mauritius. You have 3 choices, whatever you like to draw, you can draw or paint it. Am I clear to everyone?
Yeah, ma'am. Ma'am.
Ma'am, yes. I will national animal one. Mauritius.
Okay.
Ma'am. Yes. Can you please repeat?
Ma'am, I want to. Okay, ma'am, okay. I want to
just
tell something.
One by one, please guess.
Ma'am, please
raise your hand.
That.
Raise your hand and mute yourself. One by one, I'll call you by your name. Once, let me speak again for the assignment for 2 days. On Monday, we are going to visit Mauritius and you have to draw, you have 3 choices. You can draw the national flag of Mauritius, you can draw the national emblem of Mauritius, or you can draw national animal of Mauritius. Okay? So, yes, Rudra, but do you want
Monday,
to say anything?
Can I tell something?
Okay, let Rudra speak, then you, Nisa, okay?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I want to tell a national emblem is also called coat of arms.
Okay. Yes, Nesa. You are on mute, Nesa.
Ma'am, I've already been to Mauritius.
Oh, that's really great.
Ma'am, can I make a picture of Mauritius?
Ma'am, can you repeat the country name?
Okay, so if anybody wants to make PPT of Mauritius, make sure you send it us by Sunday. Okay?
Okay.
Yes, Subhanita, what do you want to say?
What, ma'am, you were not
audible. Can you
audible.
Tell the country name?
Mauritius.
Thank
we are visiting Mauritius on Monday.
And when we do a PPT, when in what we should... send to you, ma'am.
Okay, so you can take my number from the virtual tool group. The WhatsApp group you have, you can take my number from that group.
Okay, ma'am.
Because my mother has already.
Okay, so anybody else?
Ma'am?
Yeah, yes.
Ma'am, can I also present, ma'am, the PPT?
Yes, you can present. Yes.
Can I do it in the class on Monday at the end of the session?
Yes, sure. You can present it at the end of the session.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Anybody else?
Ma'am, can I also present on Monday?
Nobody else, ma'am.
Okay, we can't have number of presentations at the single time. You can do it on another day, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Just one by one, we will be having presentation sessions of each of you guys. Okay, anybody else?
Rudra is asking the name of spelling of Mauritius.
Oh, this is homework for you, Rudra. Just check the spelling of Mauritius. And can you tell me the spelling of Maldives now? Rudra, are you there?
Ma'am, Kiora knows the spelling.
No, I am asking.
Ma'am, Vanya too.
I am asking Rudra.
Ah, ma'am, Maldives.
Yes. Okay, correct. Okay, anybody else want to say anything?
Ma'am?
Ma'am, can I tell the population of Maldives?
Yes, yes, go on.
Ma'am, the population of Maldives is 3,93,253.
Oh, you are talking about population in the year of 2019. As for 2021, the population
ma'am,
has grown to 5 lakhs.
Ma'am, Rudra is telling me to control my camera.
Please don't allow it. Just decline the request.
Ma'am, what the country we are going to visit on Tuesday?
Okay, let me check. Okay, anything else from your side? Can we end the session?
On Tuesday, we will be visiting Mexico.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Okay, so if anybody wants to send the presentation, you can send in the group, the virtual world tour group. You can send your presentation by Sunday.
Okay, ma'am.
And please remember your assignment, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Bye, everyone.
Okay,
bye,
bye-bye.
Teacher.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, Mandir, ma'am.
Bye, Tanvi.
Bye, everyone, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, somebody wants to say something, yes?
Ma'am, I want to speak to Kendrick for a minute, ma'am. Kendrick D. Sibla.
Okay, please go on.
Ma'am, is he unmuted?
I can hear you. You can speak.
Yes, ma'am. I just want to tell him to phone me at 4:30 because I'm busy.
Okay.
He phones me every day at 4 o'clock. I want him to phone me today at 4:30.
Ma'am, Kendrick is my mother's boss's son.
Okay. So we can end the session now. We will see you on Monday with the new
okay, ma'am, bye, ma'am.
Bye.
A red fox can live to 12 years, ma'am.
Oh.
And a crocodile okay, can live to 25 years. Bad,
like, I will call you now because the class is over.
Bye, Maitra.
Bye, Sinvi. Thank you, Mandir, ma'am.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, Tanvi. Bye, ma'am. Thank you, Smita.